Hello everyone, this is Nimish. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to review Netflix India's first Indian series at an international level, Sacred Game, starring Saif Ali Khan, Nawazuddin Siddiqui, Radhika Apte, Kubra Seth, and many more people. This series is directed by Anurag Kashyap and Vikramaditya Motwane. Anurag Kashyap, for those of you who watched it, this is obviously going to be a general overall review of Sacred Games. By now, some everyone must have watched it. So there's not going to be detailed spoilers, but there will be general plot points here and there and the general overall aspect. So I hope you guys don't mind that. Anyway, Vikramaditya Motwane directed Saif Ali Khan's track, which is parallel to the Nawazuddin Siddiqui track directed by Anurag Kashyap. These two tracks are completely different, play out in completely different time periods, and are two different aspects of the story. Nawazuddin Siddiqui's track is probably something we should speak about first. This is the gangster track about how he became a gangster, what all he did, what his experiences were, and how he reached the point at which we are today. Of course, we are expecting more seasons, so the story is still going on, but that is basically the gist of what it tells us. It's kind of like the gangster backstory. Overall speaking, this is something we've seen obviously thousands of times in India as well as abroad in all the movies and the series that we watch. It is not something entirely or extremely unique. So right off the bat, let me say that I definitely enjoyed Saif Ali Khan's track more for a bunch of reasons. I definitely think that we've seen so much of these gangster stories that overall there was nothing new and surprising about it. Nothing about it was shocking. Nothing about it seemed to come off as new and unique or with a new flavor. There was definitely the typical gangster elements and the gangster kind of graph to it. So on a story-wise and an engagement-wise, other than the amazing performance by Nawazuddin Siddiqui and all the supporting actors with their own kind of backstories that keep you interested, the characters were absolutely interesting, but the general overall story was something very typical and predictable. But I must say that Nawazuddin Siddiqui's performance is such that it kept getting better and better and better with every episode and kept you hooked as to how this man can pull such an amazing, you know, character off. Everyone around him was also outstanding, including Kubra Seth, and I just think that everyone was so natural, so into their characters. It just felt like you're literally watching people in their real lives rather than anyone acting. And that's the biggest win for this whole story. And I think that that's the biggest takeaway. Direction-wise, again, they've tried to make it as unique as possible. But as I said, it's a story we've seen before. So no matter how much you try, you're going to find some similarities in things that you have watched. On the other side, it was completely refreshing to watch Vikramaditya Motwani's take on the Inspector track. The characters in this element were, except Saif Ali Khan, were a little less interesting than the other characters, because Saif Ali Khan's character, because of Saif Ali Khan's performance again, which is just outstanding, it's one of his best. But because of his outstanding performance, the character that is troubled, confused, a little kind of, you know, low in life, just, you know, anger sort of building up, and, you know, his need to prove to everyone what's going on, his backstory and troubles, is just such a complicated character. It was pulled off so well by Saif Ali Khan, including the whole Buffy look that he had. It just was a fantastic character. But the other characters were not so interesting. They were more kind of stereotypical. Radhika Apte, I am personally very disappointed, because initially when she started doing films, it was something different and unique, but it just seems to be very repetitive. And I was honestly, every time she came on screen, getting irritated. I also don't know how she fits the whole profile of a CBI officer, because just something about it was not natural and was not fitting. So that piece of the whole story was very disappointing, and I don't know why they are typecasting her again and again with the exact same role, exact same, you know, acting, dialogue delivery, expression. So it's not only the director and casting director's fault to let her act that way and to make her act that way, but also her fault to not being able to get something new to the table. Half of you might disagree with me, but half of you might agree that she is just doing the same thing over and over again, and it is not enough. Anyway, the other characters were pretty good. Kartikar, who is Jitendra, played by Jitendra Joshi, a great Marathi actor, was extremely natural. But again, the character generally was very, so to speak, you know, the sidekick, the kind of funny guy, the kind of, you know, light entertainment that you get while watching such characters, the Havaldar, so to speak. That's what he played. So the character was not very well written, but he, again, with his performance, elevated it to the next level. Then there was Parulkar, who again was a stereotypical grey character in the police force. You don't know whether he's on the left or the right side of the game. Things are going, he's at a level of authority, but you can't predict what's going on with him. Amazing actor, again, pulled up the character to another level. So you can see that in these two stories, the parallels are that on one story, Saif Ali Khan's story, the characters may be pretty standard, but the performances elevated it to the next level. Whereas on the other side, there were some unique characterizations and great performances, but the storyline overall was kind of predictable. So this kind of adla badli, this kind of, you know, give and take from both aspects of the story by both directors actually ended up as a good finished product. If Sacred Games was only about Nawazuddin, I'm sure half the people would have felt there's nothing new to this. If Sacred Games was only about Saif Ali Khan, you might have got a little bored after a first four or five episodes. So I think that the contrast that these two have and the way that they are made fits together very well. And that's what works overall for Sacred Games. You have variety, you have, you know, different things going on because of the different parallel storylines. You're building up towards something that's going to be very more interesting. You're putting in plot points about actual events that happened in India, news events, big events, political events. And with that backdrop, you're kind of pushing the story forward and creating circumstances to develop the characters, which is all very interesting. I have not read the original book, but I'm sure most of this is from the book, which is obviously very well written. Moving on to what might happen next, I'm not going to predict, I have no idea and I don't want to know, but based on certain interviews and feedback and discussions from people, it might be more about the games and the Sacred Games element of it, which we've not seen so much yet. So it might be more about that, and there might be more because, you know, he finds that clue which was all over the series and things like that, he finds that thing. So it might be more about the whole Sacred Games aspect coming in going forward, but also it's going to probably be directed by someone else. And so that might get a new angle on the direction. All international series, if you watch, every episode or every other episode is directed by some other director. This is not to kind of, you know, just for the sake of doing it, but to give a different directorial perspective and keep the series interesting. That is probably what kind of got missed in terms of the storytelling, wherein Anurag Kashyap did the whole Nawazuddin piece and Vikramaditya Motwani did the whole Saif Ali Khan piece. It, for some people, might get a little repetitive and boring in terms of the directorial style because that doesn't change. And therefore, they are probably changing up the directors in the next season. But I hope that they also make it multiple directors, at least four directors total, for the Nawaz story, two for the Saif story, so that people get hooked on to this whole kind of narration and narrative of Sacred Games. However, that being said, this was really, really something that has lived up to expectations, not even 1% below expectations. From some people that I've got feedback from, they found it a little boring, they found it a little too bold. For the other people, they found it extremely interesting. And for the most part, people have enjoyed it and are looking forward to season 2. So I'm extremely happy for Saif Ali Khan and Nawazuddin Siddiqui, Anurag Kashyap, Vikramaditya Motwani and everyone in the cast. I'm truly overjoyed about it. And I honestly wish them luck in the future season, which is going to take long, long time. You know, it comes out, we watch it within a week and then you just have to wait for another year. But it was an experience. I'm hoping that, you know, the complete story and the complete series gets more interesting with time. I'm hoping that some of the cliched characters are kind of fading away and some new surprising elements are thrown in there. I'm hoping that some of, you know, something that we don't expect from season 1 happens in season 2. Just something in the show. It can't go on with the same kind of template, and I'm sure that they're working on that. Overall, as again, this was an enjoyable experience. I really enjoyed watching the whole series. not like the other series that are out in India, which I don't want to name, from big partners that I could not watch past a couple of episodes. In fact, Netflix India itself has made a couple of movies in India, some of which were good, some of which I couldn't watch beyond, you know, half an hour. So it's really good that they gave a quality product out there, and I hope this puts India on the map for being able to make great series. I hope you like this review to Sacred Games for season 1. I am going with 3 out of 5 stars. That is exactly where it is, right in the center. I'm hoping we can push it up to 4 for the next season. I hope you like this review. If you have not yet watched Sacred Games, obviously check it out. But if you're still watching this video, you've probably watched Sacred Games. So like, comment, share, subscribe this video. Definitely leave your thoughts on what you think about Sacred Games and what you think about my thoughts as well. Leave your own thoughts as well. And keep watching for more.